girl helps a mighty man. Do you know what this little girl is saying? She is telling the lady about Jehovah's prophet Elisha, and the wonderful things that Jehovah helps him to do. The lady does not know about Jehovah because she is not an Israelite. Let's see, then, why the girl is in the lady's home. The lady is a Syrian. Her husband is Naaman, the chief of the Syrian army. The Syrians had captured this little Israelite girl, and she was brought to Naaman's wife to be her servant. Naaman has a bad sickness called leprosy. This sickness can even cause some of a person's flesh to fall off. So this is what the girl is telling Naaman's wife: I wish my master could go to Jehovah's prophet in Israel. He would heal him of his leprosy. Later this is told to the lady's husband. Naaman wants very much to be healed, so he decides to go to Israel. When he gets there, he goes to Elisha's house. Elisha has his servant go out and tell Naaman to go wash in the Jordan River 7 times. This makes Naaman very angry, and he says, "The rivers back home are better than any river in Israel." After saying this, Naaman leaves. But one of his servants tells him, "Sir, if Elisha told you to do something hard, you would do it. Now why can't you just wash yourself, as he said?" Naaman listens to his servant and goes and dips himself in the Jordan River 7 times. When he does, his flesh becomes firm and healthy. Naaman is very happy. He returns to Elisha and tells him, "Now I know for sure that the God in Israel is the only true God in all the earth. So, please, take this gift from me." But Elisha answers, "No, I will not take it." Elisha knows that it would be wrong for him to take the gift, because it was Jehovah who had healed Naaman. But Elisha's servant Jehazi wants the gift for himself. So this is what Jehazi does. After Naaman leaves, Jehazi runs to catch up with him. Elisha sent me to tell you that he would like some of your gift for friends who just came to visit, Jehazi says. This, of course, is a lie. But Naaman doesn't know that it is a lie, so he gives Jehazi some of the things. When Jehazi returns home, Elisha knows what he has done. Jehovah has told him. So he says, "Because you did this bad thing, Naaman's leprosy will come upon you." And it does, right away. What can we learn from all of this? First, that we should be like the little girl and talk about Jehovah. It can do much good. Secondly, we should not be proud as Naaman was at first, but we should obey God's servants. And thirdly, we should not lie as Jehazi did. Can't we learn a lot from reading the Bible? 2 Kings 5:1-27.
Diego Chapa. Tex-Mex video, we are Chicanos and proud of it.